Hello everyone, Farel the Gecko here. I've been feeling pretty lifeless as of late, and so I decided it's only fitting that I play The Walking Dead. Just to explain, I have little to no connection with this game, the show that I assume that it's based on. No connections, I just was recommended to play it. Kind of friend suggested that I do it. I wanted to let's play this game at some point, so let's have a go at it. Let's play it safe. This game series adapts to the Telltale Games presents. A new day. Graphics seem quite stylized, if I'm not wrong.
Well, I reckon you didn't do it then.
Why do you say that?
You know, I've driven a bunch of fellas down to this prison. Lord knows how many. Usually it's about now I get the, I didn't do it.
Every time?
Every time.
I could count the trees.
I followed your case a little bit, you being a making boy and all.
Oh boy.
You're from Macon, then?
Yep. Came up to Atlanta to be a city cop in the 70s. Always wanted to work a murder case, like that senatorial mess you got yourself mixed up in. With all due respect. A real shame, that is. Hell, the whole family used to be regulars at your folks' drugstore right in downtown. Still there?
Sure is.
Good.
Any of that seem important to you?
All of it, but that box never shuts up. Sit in this seat and pay too much attention and you'll drive yourself crazy. I got a nephew up at UGA. You teach there long?
Going on my 6th year.
You meet your wife in Athens? You want to know how I see it?
Oh boy.
Sure.
Regardless, could be you just married the wrong woman.
What? I made a choice, but it didn't happen. Kind of odd, so I'm not allowed to make some choices?
I'm driving this man once. He was the worst one. He wouldn't stop going on about how he didn't do it. He was an older fella, big soft eyes behind a pair of smart folk glasses. And he just wailing back there. Says it wasn't him. Crying and snotting all over right where you're sitting.
All officers are available for incoming 217.
Then before long, he starts kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. And I tell him he's got to stop. But that's government property, and I'll be forced to zap him otherwise. So he stops, and having exhausted all his options, he starts crying out for his mama. Mama, it's all a big mistake. It wasn't me.
So did he do it?
They caught the fucker red-handed, stabbing his wife, cutting her up as the boys came through the door. He sits in my car screaming bloody murder that it wasn't him. I think he actually believed it himself. It goes to show, people will up and go mad when they believe their life is over. I got another good one for you. This one's a little bit less depressing and a bit more hilarious, if I do say so. This other time...
What? Oh boy. Well, things sure got bloody all of a sudden. Would that really be that easy to do? Okay, it takes a bit to break it open. Yeah, let's look at the door, use the mouse wheel, select an option. Oh boy, I'm sorry guys if I'm bad at commentating all this. I'm just really confused as to what's happening.
Officer? God damn. Officer? The officer's shotgun is over there.
Shotgun shelf? Oh.
Why would he have needed that?
So why do I need the shotgun shells if I... Never mind.
God damn.
Okay, so where do I go? Can't go to the left. Oh. Might as well take him.
Shit.
Yeah, it wouldn't be so easy to take them. I seriously have to press the buttons each time.
Officer? Holy shit!
Did I really mess up that quickly? You are dead.
You are dead. You are dead.
Thought you were
hot. Seriously, I forgot where the S key is. Okay.
Officer?
That still got me.
Holy shit!
Okay, S.
Get away from me! What in the hell?
Shit! Okay, come on.
Don't make me do this!
What?
No! Get the fuck away!
What are these 4 points? What am I supposed to do? What? What?
You are dead.
What on earth?
Officer?
It gets me every time. Okay. Press.
Get away from me! Where the hell are you?
Come on, let's.
Don't make me do this!
Achievement unlocked? Out of the prying pan.
His skin's all rotten and he smells like shit. What the hell is this?
Good question. Mysterious figure.
Help! Go get someone! There's been a shooting!
Zombies everywhere. Yeah, they're slow as ever, but yeah, with a limping leg, it's gonna be tough. No. It's a backyard. Hope there are good shotgun shells here too. Okay.
Hello? Anybody?
So, Does this mean that a zombie apocalypse just happened? And
I wonder if anybody's home. No ladder. I'm not getting up there anyway. This leg, the way it is.
T-set. Yeah, because I am certain that'll be important.
Fill one of those teacups with some bourbon if I could.
Help!
Is it mean to demand a run button when a character, well, is limping? What is this? Oh, a pool.
Maybe I'll just go for a dip.
Time and place, protagonist.
Somebody! Yell if you can hear me!
I wonder if anybody's home. I wonder if anybody's home.
Oh, so let's... Oh yeah, that's... Let's try
over. Hello? Anybody home? I need a little help.
Yeah, it would be awkward of me to do that, but he's wounded, so exceptions have to be made.
Is there anybody here?
Can I walk here? Nope.
Maybe I should just check inside the house through the glass door before wandering out into the neighborhood.
Strange man here. Bleeding in your backyard.
Okay, the guy has a sense of humor. I like that. Yeah, I'm definitely not supposed to go there. Oh, so there's a third option now.
Coming in. Don't shoot, okay?
I'm dead.
Hello? I'm not an intruder. Or one of them.
These people may need more help than I do.
Gosh, this game is kind of spooky. Okay.
Oh, Jesus.
Wait. Are those... God. Why? I was trying to point out that the footsteps are...
What's that beeping?
Yeah, what?
This place has been ransacked. Just about anything worthwhile is gone.
Yeah, let's not dehydrate. Let's look in this drawer. Oh! A radio. What's going on with that radio? And this drawer. This drawer. Nothing.
There are three new messages.
Wait, what?
The Marsh House. That's a Savannah area code. But that's the type of note you'd leave a babysitter.
What's that noise? That must be it. Answering.
Maybe there's something on there.
Three new messages. Message one, left at 5:43 p.m.
Hey, Sandra. This is Diana. We're still in Savannah. Ed had a little incident with some crazy guy near the hotel, so we had to get him back to the ER and have it checked out. Anyway, he's not feeling well enough to drive back tonight, so we're staying an extra day. Thanks so much for looking after Clementine, and I promise we'll be back in time before your spring break.
Message 2. Left at 11:19 p.m.
Oh my god, finally. I don't know if you tried to reach us. All the calls are getting dropped. They're not letting us leave and aren't telling us anything about Atlanta. Please, please, just leave the city and take Clementine with you back to Murrieta. I've got to get back to the hospital. Please let me know that you're safe.
Message 3. Left at 6:51 a.m.
Clementine, baby. If you can hear this, call the police. That's 911. We love you. We love you. We love you.
Oh, boy.
Daddy?
Huh? Hello?
You need to be quiet.
Who is this?
I'm Clementine. This is my house.
Hi, Clementine. I'm Lee.
You're not my daddy.
No, I'm not.
Guess not. I guess I'll ask this.
Where are your parents?
They took a trip and left me with Sandra. They're in Savannah, I think, where the boats are.
Where are you?
I'm outside in my treehouse. They can't get in.
That's smart.
See? Can you see me? I can see you through the window.
Cute. Oh god. God damn it. Get it, get it. Thank you. And this. And this. And this. And another one. As a bonus. Achievement unlocked. Adventures in babysitting.
Man.
Nice.
Hi there.
Did you kill it?
Hope so.
I don't know. I think so.
Sometimes they come back.
Have you killed one?
No, but they get shot a lot.
You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
I think that might be a little while, you know?
Oh.
Look, I don't know what happened, but I'll look after you until then.
What should we do now?
Yeah, we should look for help.
We need to find help before it gets dark.
Yeah, it's not safe at night.
Yeah, indeed.
Let's go. Stay close to me.
This sure is kind of unsettling. What is this blue icon? The white icon. Should I activate it somehow, or...? Man. People!
I ain't never getting home to Mama at this rate.
This sucks.
Oh, it's hot dish night.
Hello?
What's the matter?
Should I stay?
What?
I don't want to sleep in the treehouse tonight, but I don't know if I should leave. What if my parents come home?
I won't leave you alone.
Let's go somewhere safe that's close, okay?
That's a good idea.
Yeah, we should not leave her alone.
Hey, man!
Holy shit!
Don't eat us!
We're not gonna hurt you.
Yeah. Thought for a second you and the little one were both gonna give us the chomp.
Ooh.
We need help.
Are you trying to get out of here? Because you should be. Those things are all over the damn place. I haven't seen anything as gnarly as this neighborhood since downtown Atlanta, 15 miles back. I'm Sean. Sean Green.
Lee, this is Clementine.
I'm Chet.
We shouldn't be out in the open like this. How about you help us clear the way, and we'll take you and your daughter out of here and down to my family's farm. It should be safer there.
I'm not a dad. Just some guy.
Some guy?
Yeah.
She's alone? Let's get going. Staying put for too long is a mistake.
I'm a bad liar.
What do you want to do?
I...
The monster's coming.
We gotta go. Leave quick. Let's go.
Oh, we were trying to do.
For just some guy, it seems like you saved a bunch of lives today.
Oh, well, thank you. Achievement unlocked? In your charge? I'm not sure where this is all going. I don't know if this is a good place to be. Not sure what-
Hey Sean, I'm gonna run on home. My mama's gonna be in a snit.
No sweat, man. I'll catch you tomorrow night.
It was nice to meet you both.
Okay, I don't know what would be a safe place during a zombie apocalypse, but...
Thank God you're okay.
I was worried it'd be bad here, too.
Been quiet as usual the past couple days. Old Brecken down the way thinks his mare's gone lame, but that ain't nothing new.
I wouldn't have made it back without Chet.
Well, I'm glad you took him with you then. You've brought a couple guests.
Your boy's a lifesaver.
Glad he could be a help to somebody. So it's just you and your daughter, then?
Oh, not his daughter. He's, well, just some guy who found her alone.
Honey, do you know this man?
Yes.
Okay, then. Well, looks like you hurt your leg pretty bad there.
Yeah, it's not doing so good.
I can help you out. Sean, run on in and check on your sister. You, take a seat up on the porch and I'll go see what I have. Let's have a look. Yeah, this is swollen to hell.
It hurts like hell.
Yeah, let's be honest.
I bet it does. What did you say your name was?
It's Lee.
Nice to meet you, Lee. I'm Herschel Green. How'd this happen?
Car accident.
That's so. Where are you headed before the car accident?
Home.
Where's home?
I grew up in Macon. We hit a guy. One of those things you've been hearing about. On the road.
Who are you with, the girl?
Nobody.
Is that so?
Yeah, it is.
You said we, that's all.
Oh.
The house is full up with mine. We got another displaced family of three sleeping in the barn. You and your daughter are welcome to rest there when we're done here. I didn't catch your name, darling.
Clementine.
Can't imagine what you've been through, Clementine.
I'm looking after her until we find her parents.
Hey, Dad, so I'm thinking, first thing tomorrow, we gotta reinforce the fence around the farm.
That doesn't seem necessary.
I don't know what you saw on TV or heard on the radio, but there's some serious shit hitting the fan. I don't think anyone knows how big it is yet.
I agree.
Your son's right. You're going to want to fortify this place.
Stuff like that doesn't happen around here, Sean.
Dad, I'm serious. Lee, come on. Tell him what you saw out there, man.
I got chased by a couple of dead people.
Well, do what you think you should. We got plenty of chores as it is.
Lee and those folks in the barn can help out in the morning. We got to do it. Really.
I already said okay.
Hmm.
Well, I'm all done here. It should start to feel better tomorrow.
Thanks.
If your leg gets hot or the swelling doesn't go down, you're probably dealing with an infection.
What do we do then?
We'll probably just have to shoot you.
Do it.
We'll clean it, redress it, and you'll be fine.
Okay, that'd be preferable.
There's blankets and such in the barn. We'll be seeing you bright and early. Come tomorrow, which way you think you're headed?
Towards Macon, I suppose. All right, then.
It smells like...
I know what it smells like.
Duty. I missed my mom and dad.
I bet, Clem.
How far is Savannah?
Pretty far.
Oh, okay.
What was that? I don't like the sound of that.
Okay. Hey, get up.
Who are you?
I'm itchy.
Well, you slept in a barn, little lady. Lucky you don't have spiders in your hair. But I bet your daddy scared them all away, huh?
I'm, not her dad. Name's Lee.
I'm Kenny.
Dad, we're in the middle of a fence! There's a tractor and everything!
We better get going, or we won't hear the end of it. That's my boy, Ken Jr. We call him Duck, though.
Huh?
Duck?
Yeah, nothing bothers him. Like water off a duck's back, you know?
That's a valuable treat lately.
No kidding. But frankly, I think it's because he's dumb as a bag of hammers.
Dad!
But he makes up for it with enthusiasm. The word is, you were on your way to Macon.
My family's from there.
Well, Macon's on the way, and personally, I'd appreciate the company of a guy who can knock a couple of heads together if he has to.
Huh? Maybe. We'll see how things shake out with this Herschel guy.
Good luck with that. He's a hard ass. Honey, Duck, this is Lee. And, what's the girl's name?
Clementine.
Clementine.
That is a very pretty name.
Thanks.
Well, we should get to work. We've all seen what those things can do out there, so the faster we get this fence up, the better.
Agreed. I want to build a fence.
Yeah? Well, I need a good foreman. You can sit on the tractor and yell at me whenever I take a water break.
On the tractor? Cool!
Duck and I will hop to it.
I can keep an eye on your little girl here on the porch. We can visit.
Man, it's been a while since I was on a farm. Be sure to check with everyone you've met so far. Okay.
Seems like those two are getting along.
Kenny?
Hey there, Kenny. So what's your family's plan?
Get back on down to Lauderdale and let this mess get sorted out. Government will start handing out shots and the National Guard will do its thing. On the odd chance things got too bad, we could hop on my boat, I guess.
You've got a boat?
I'm a commercial fisherman, catching mackerel, dolphin, whatever's biting and paying. Katya wouldn't be wild about it, but the boat's not that bad.
Need any help?
No, I think I got it. Do you need any help?
What do you mean?
I mean, in taking care of that little girl. You know what you're doing? You got kids of your own?
Nah, no kids.
Would have liked one then.
You know. How's your son doing?
Good, I think. Katya's got a sister up in Memphis. We were coming back from visiting her. We were in a gas station, and some guy grabbed my boy. I thought he was kidnapping him. I was on the fucker in about 2 seconds, and... Christ. Just lucky I was there. We saw a lot of bodies before we stumbled upon Herschel's.
Oh, God.
We're a tough family, Lee. Ain't nothing gonna faze us.
See you.
You showed an interest in his family. And that's... good or bad? Seriously, what's with the phone icon? Why is it glowing all the time? Tractor.
Sean's still working on that fence.
Yeah, he is.
Hey, Lee.
Need a hand?
That'd be great. If you could cut those two-bys to length, that sure speed things up.
Okay, let's try.
Dad doesn't know how bad it is.
No, he doesn't.
I saw a guy in Atlanta kill a kid. A boy. Just shot him right in the face.
Was the boy one of the walkers?
I don't even know. He was either attacking the guy or asking for help. He didn't even hesitate. He just turned, put the barrel of the gun right between the kid's eyes, and pulled the trigger. You don't see things like that. It's not like in the movies.
They don't fall like you think.
Did you have to do it?
Do what?
Kill. Have you had to off one yet?
Oh, I had to shoot one.
I could shoot one, maybe, if it were far away. I'm just glad we're getting this fence built. Dad just wants to keep the family safe and thinks inviting people in is a bigger threat than whatever's out there.
Certainly.
How about yours? How's your family?
My brother and parents are in Macon, I hope.
Oh man, I hope so too. Maybe it's not too bad there. That's probably all I need cut for now. Thanks.
You're welcome.
And Sean, thanks again for the ride.
No problem, Lee. Couldn't leave you behind. Anyway, when you see my dad around, he might want some help in the barn.
I'm slowing down. Did someone say manure?
You should know that if you weren't leaving with Kenny today, I wouldn't stand for your lack of honesty last night.
I'm not sure I follow.
I ain't dumb. I caught you in that lie last night about who you were with in that car. And honestly, I don't even want to know. How'd you get out of Atlanta?
I got a ride and then I was in a wreck. I walked until your boy found me.
Well, you're no worse for wear.
This farm's a nice plot of land.
Had you told me 20 years ago I'd still be doing this, I would have told you that you were full of crap. Never was a plan, having a place like this. It was in the family, and I guess so was I. Family's important. It's all that matters. You agree with that?
Was brought up to, yes.
Where's your family now? Parents? Wife? Girlfriend?
No wife. Yeah. Not anymore. I think she's up in Virginia, maybe.
Sorry to hear it. But now you've got this little girl to take care of. Clementine, is it? You just stumbled up on her?
Yeah. I was looking for help in her house.
Can I give you a piece of advice?
What is it?
I don't know who you are or what you did. Let's say things don't get better back in the cities, or they get worse before they do. You're gonna have to depend on the honesty of strangers if you're gonna make it. And if those same people get to questioning yours, you're gonna be in trouble. Oh, and I'd start checking the attitude, friend.
Go! I'll get my gun!
Oh, boy.
Worried about that.
Please,
Just go.
Get out and never come back.
You've got that ride to Macon if you want it.
Good Lord. This got uncomfortable. Okay.
Well, this is as far as we're going.
And it's far enough.
I've already made some choices, which I... God damn it.
Look!
Hey there! You friendly? Truck's run out of gas.
No.
Fuck!
We're trapped!
No! God damn it.
Run!
We can't take risks like this. And we can't just let people die, either. When I say that door stays shut no matter what, I fucking mean it. We don't know who these people are. It could be dangerous.
Worse, they could have led them right to us.
Where the hell is your humanity? They would have died out there.
Then we let them.
We can't trust anybody. We already know that.
You'll have to excuse her.
The hell he or anyone will. This is about survival. Do you guys not see what's happening?
What is it?
I'd go out there again in a second.
I bet you would.
In a minute, Clem.
They've got kids, Lily.
Those things outside don't care.
Maybe you should go join them then. You'll have something in common.
God damn it, Lily. You have to control these people.
Carly and Glenn just ran out there.
I don't give a flying fuck. We're in a war zone.
Lee, can you believe this lady?
That lady's my daughter.
I can see the resemblance. My son won't grow up to be a raging fucking lunatic, that's for certain.
Son? Holy shit.
Son of a bitch. One of them is bitten.
He wasn't bitten.
Hell he wasn't. We have to end this now.
Over my dead body.
We'll dig one hole.
No, I'm cleaning him up. There's no bite. He's fine.
Don't you fucking people get it? We've already seen this happen. We let someone with a bite stay in, and we all end up bitten.
Shut up.
We gotta throw him out, or smash his head in.
Kenny, stop him!
What do we do about this guy?
Dad, it's just a boy. It's...
Lily, I'll handle this.
But your heart, Dad. You need to calm down.
We reason with him.
With the bloody end of an axe handle, maybe. Nobody threatens my boy.
Everyone, chill the fuck out!
Nobody is doing anything.
Shut up, Lily. And you, shut the fuck up. They will find us, and they will get in here. And none of this will fucking matter. But right now, we're about to be trapped in here with one of those things.
What the hell are you talking about?
He's bitten! That's how you turn!
He's not bitten. Please stop this. It's upsetting him.
Oh, I'm upsetting him. Upsetting is getting eaten alive.
Dad, we get it. It's a big deal.
What if this was your daughter?
Never would have happened. She's not some snot-nosed toddler, okay? She's United States Air Force.
Fuck you and her. I'm gonna kill him, Cat. Just worry about Duck.
Lee!
Yeah?
There's someone in there.
It's just locked. Key's behind the counter.
No.
Hey, I'm not the bad guy here. I'm just looking out for my daughter.
No, you're just the guy arguing for killing a kid.
He's covered in muck.
She'll find the bite. Watch!
She won't.
And if she does, the first thing he'll do is sink his teeth into his mom's face. Then, once she's dead, he'll probably pounce on your little girl. She'll turn fast. And then, there'll be three. And that, boy, is the ball game. Which pretty much seals the deal for me. We're throwing him out.
No! You don't touch that boy! You don't touch anybody! I've got a little girl I'm trying to protect in here, too. You wanna get violent, you old fuck? Well, come on! You better have a plan to kill me, though, because it's me before anyone else in here!
I knew it!
Jesus! Come in time!
You okay?
Just great, thanks.
Guys? Everybody down! Stay quiet!
We're gonna get in! Shut up!
Is that the military?
I don't know.
Thank God for whatever it is.
We almost died because of this bitch and her itchy trigger finger! That was stupid! That was...
Dad!
What's wrong with it?
It's his heart.
My pills.
Nitroglycerin pills?
Yes, we're out. We've been trying to get into the pharmacy since we got here. Please try to get in there. Behind the counter where the pills are.
There's probably another entrance. Maybe through the office.
How do you know that's an office?
Educated guess.
It doesn't matter. We need nitroglycerin pills. Please get in there. I'll keep an eye on my dad.
Everyone else should get comfy and look for anything useful. We could be in here a while.
I'm starting to think this drugstore isn't a permanent solution.
You're right. This ain't exactly Fort Knox.
What do you suggest?
We need as much gas as possible so we can all get out of downtown Macon. Fast.
Agreed.
Then I'll head out and get gas. There's a motel not too far from here, out towards the end of Peachtree. I'll work my way towards it and then loop back, siphoning what I can.
You know your way around? Local?
Born and raised.
If you're gonna do that, here's a walkie-talkie if you get in a tight spot. Hopefully, you won't need it.
Cool.
Clementine's got the other one. Check in with her and get back here as soon as you can.
And you? What's your name?
It's Lily. My dad's Larry.
Keep a good eye on him. These boys will work on getting you your medicine.
That's right.
And you? You keep an eye on that front door. You're our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly. You'll shift in with Doug when he needs it. For now, get some rest. You're a good shot, and I'd like to keep it that way.
You got it, boss.
Now get him those pills.
Okay, I think this is enough for one sitting. How do I save my game? Or does it save automatically? Well, I hope so. Well, any progress since last autosave? No, I have to quit. I have to accept it. Okay, so,
That was a play session. I'm grateful for following. I'm grateful that you watched me play this game, and I guess I'll try to do a full Let's Play of this, because, what's that sound? Well, seriously, what is it? Dancing in the moonlight, everybody. Wait. Telltale Games is releasing a Guardians of the Galaxy video game?